What's up, everybody? Metalbanger Dude coming at you here. It has been a very long week, but you know, I want to show you guys something here real quick. A friend of mine, Mark Garbowski, did for me. Really cool. Says Dirty D there. I don't know if you can make that out or not, but I can't hear me. So I got, they're called Black Winter Seymour Duncan pickups in there, and they sound insanely incredible. Yeah, he did everything for me, painted it, put the dirty on here that's under lacquer, and then he got the Dirty D headstock truss rod cover for me. Very cool. And yeah, but oh, and then he also put in these D'Addario tuners in here for me. These are locking tuners, so it's much more difficult for it to go out of tune. But also when you restring it, your thing, it automatically cuts the string off for you too. That's why you don't see any layover on the strings. So it's very cool, man. Very cool. Yeah, plays beautifully. I thought that was so fucking cool. So thank you, Mark. Appreciate it, man. It is Saturday, and yesterday, as I stated, you guys, had to take a day off for Mama. We had to celebrate Valentine's Day. I think I told you guys, but we made this deal because, you know, she's all about the Hallmark holidays and all that crap. And so she used to want to make me celebrate Sweetest Day. And I said, enough is enough. And so we made the agreement that I would kind of do things right on Valentine's Day, and that we would completely ignore Sweetest Day. So that's what's happening. I'm a little out of sorts here because I've been working on music all week long, all kinds of different stuff. So I'm a little disoriented right now, but here we are. And Daniel did a PayPal me. We're going to do a couple songs for him tonight. And the first one we're going to do is Kendrick Lamar, The Heart Part 2. Now, I very much remember Kendrick Lamar, The Heart Part 3, I think it was. I'm pretty sure that was it. Anyway, and it was a monster. I remember just the first time I heard it, and I've listened to it many, many times since, but the first time I heard it, I remember just being blown away. So always down to do some Kendrick Lamar, and Daniel is kind of my go-to guy for, you know, I have go-to guys and a couple gals for certain stuff. And, you know, I've got a couple country guys. I got definitely a Tech Nine guy. You know who you are. And then Kendrick Lamar guy, and Eminem. I got several Eminem guys. I'm going to state it again, man. That fucking album, I've listened to that a dozen times now. A dozen times. It's insane. So, you know, while we're doing this, this is something I wanted to kind of throw at you guys and get your feedback on, something I've been tossing up, and that is maybe doing a live feed on YouTube. Obviously, we can't get through the copyright. So I have a little Bluetooth speaker. So I was thinking about playing it through my Bluetooth speaker. It would definitely bleed through the microphone, but not much. And so it would probably not get blocked as easy, at least. Because that's why I don't do them, because it ends up getting blocked. I've tried it three times now, and every time it's got blocked. So, and what I do is I don't even talk. I just click on it and I have music playing as I click on it, and it blocks it just like that. So, give me your thoughts on that. See what you guys think. Just something I've been tossing up in the old noodle up here, and it's an old noodle. Kendrick Lamar, The Heart Part 2.
I'll tell you what, this I don't believe. Can I do that? All right, I don't believe in the laws or the question, system probably. By any means whatsoever. I try not to obey them at any time.
It's clearly a white dude, right?
That's what I believe in, not believing in.
So what keeps you alive?
Dude.
4 big bottles of water a day, 2 packs of Marlboro Reds, and what keeps me alive? Shit. Music. I have to listen to music all day long. I'd say that keeps me going. I'm a pretty dark person. I've thought about ending it a million times, and I have to say the music keeps me here. By far the main thing.
Thank you.
You know what? I'm going to back this up here a smidge. I'm having a problem with my mouse for some reason, and I'm very sorry. I think I got to buy a new mouse. You know, and I think we've talked about this before. Music can be a difference maker, you know, and I've told you myself that I've gotten through some really dark times, especially when I was really young. An early teenager, and I had a rough way to go with things, you know, adjusting to a different lifestyle, going from the suburbs to the hood real quick, overnight, literally, and it was a serious adjustment for me, and there were certain songs that I'd listen to make me feel better, and, you know, I never thought of ending it, but it was definitely a dark time. You know, and so I can relate to that, man. There's a lot of truth in what he said.
By far, the main thing.
So,
thank you.
Sitting in the studio thinking about which move would go right now. Freestyle or write down, whatever. It's still a come up clever. I just need to free my thoughts, and Lord knows that I know better. But I ain't perfect, I ain't seen too many churches or know them testament verses. You should either hear me now or go deaf, or end up dead, die trying and no death. Might end up dead, swallow blood, swallow my breath. Fuck a funeral, just make sure you pay my music respect, nigga. I mean that from the bottom of my heart. You see my heart is all I have, and victory tastes sweet. Even when the enemy can throw salt, still knock them out the park like a fucking tow car. Let bygones be bygones, but where I'm from, we buy guns and more guns to give to the young. I'm living the life of a nigga, trap nigga. Inside the system, all you envision is trap niggas. My uncle doing life inside prison, he wasn't rap too tight. He told me rap about life, not rap niggas. That's why I'm shaking my head when you rap dissing. My stomach start turning, my nerves get to twitching. I start evaluating, then my final intuition is that you wishing to come up, well just come up. We used to beefing over turf, fuck beefing over a verse. Niggas dying, motherfucker double entendre. And this is Compton, lions in the land of the triumph. Raps around our defiance, ban our alliance. Put burners in the hand of the black man. One hood with 24 foes like a clone Kobe Bryant. You probably heard I wanna be heard and wonder who I am. You probably even listened to fake and think I know Zion, but really I'm just caught in a loop of understanding the truth, because it seems like it's always clashing with science. I got a big fear of flying, my future's so bright I probably go blind before I blink twice. I ain't lying, I swear to God, half of y'all.
Okay, let me back that up. So yeah, you know, we know what Kendrick Lamar brings to the table by now. When I say we, I mean me. when he starts getting this fervor going, when he starts getting emotional, that's when he starts reeling me in. Lyrically, he's unmatched, in my opinion, in today's age. You know, I'm not one of these that's going to put him ahead of Pac, but that's just my personal thing, okay? But You know, people that didn't grow up on Pac, and I think I've said this before, people that didn't grow up on Pac, which I didn't, but what I'm referring to are the people that grew up after Pac listening to rap, their first introductions were probably Kendrick Lamar, and as far as depth goes. And so I can see where a lot of people would feel that way. But where he starts taking over, in my mind, is when he starts getting into that feverish pitch and you start feeling the emotions that he brings, man, and it's just unmatched. It's unmatched. I love when he starts doing that. That's why I love watching the live stuff, because he starts letting it hang out, man. He goes in deep, and there's no mistaking what he's feeling.
Line. I swear to God, half of y'all just don't know Kendrick. The school of hard knocks, we was the first ones in attendance. You walking down the block, he got shot, you are no eyewitness. You just mind your business. You just turn your head, kneel down, and then tie your tennis. It's kind of scary, ain't it? You can't act like no bitch that only got Tyler Perry famous. Just let me explain it. Why you pick up that stainless? Cause your pops wasn't anxious to see you when you hate it. So much you probably had your burner tucked at graduation. Said if you see him on them bleachers, then you kill him. Facing 25 to life with a murder charge. Your enemies was the prey, and now you pray to God. I pray these balls get farther than Compton. And if I wreck and if I break, I still won't break my promise. I promise to keep it honest. Secret society, all we access trust. And all we lack is communication, like service sucks. The people scared of annihilation when kingdom come. And I'm like, the Kendrick Lamar OD in less than a month, alright? Gotta keep it pushing. Can't let the government tell me how my future looking. I'm on Rosecrans and Central trying to duck the central bookings. If the fucking pigs get behind me, then you know I'm booking. Never will I surrender. I've been a warrior when I came out my mom's placenta. In the gutter lane like a master splinter. How splendid, I guess my project had did it. Got all these niggas approaching, they mixtape different. They said 7 tracks, I said 15. Called it an EP, they said I'm tripping. But little did they know I'm trying to change the rules that we've been confined to, so the corporate won't make decisions. Up in these bitches, handling business.
Too late.
Killing our dreams, stealing our vision. Out in Haiti, adolescents barely have a home. In LA, everybody think they fucking own. Hop on Twitter, perpetrate, we doing big shit. Who we hanging with and bragging about the iPhone? I swear to God, most of y'all cats just don't know Kendrick. You barely know yourself, so I guess most of y'all should be offended. Ain't doing this for my health, I'm trying to purchase my mama them business. Occupying my time with riches. Justifying my time ambition, just to coincide, just to go inside. Put together the life while we live. And look, the mastermind took the mastermind, just the perfect time, just the mastermind, just the mastermind with precision. Look, the mastermind took the.
We would like to call this an appreciation tape for those who recognize the Kendrick Lamar EP. For this is the Kendrick Lamar OD. OD. Because of you, we are overly dedicated. OD. OD.
Oh, man, that's what I'm talking about, man. When he starts going in like that, it's just, I know it's about to get real. But ding, ding. By the way, anybody see the fucking Conor McGregor commercial? I said something about it on Twitter. He used the term ding, ding. What about the box? I'll bring Nate with me. No, but that was a really cool vibe in the backdrop. I was trying to listen to everything on the back end too, because Kendrick always brings awesome beats, and I know he's not necessarily doing them all, but you know, when the king is in the house, you bring the beats, right? So, but that was a really cool vibe in the background. And that's something else that I noticed he does a lot, is he does that contrasting thing that I like so much, to where, you know, what he's talking about is real shit, but then you kind of got this smooth, jazzy thing going on in the background. So it kind of gives it a lot more texture to it. I really, really like that about Kendrick. So, yeah, right on, man. Metal Bugger Dude, peace.